Hello everyone, welcome back to a new tutorial video. Last time we talked about CMD commands, but this time we're going to be talking about Ubuntu commands, a Linux distribution-based system. I am Dave Zachary Makaraya.
And I am Brennan Gunier.
And we are here to talk about Ubuntu. So what is Ubuntu?
What is Ubuntu? Ubuntu is a Linux-based operating system. It is a design for computers, smartphones, and network servers. The system is developed by a UK-based company called Canonical Ltd. All the principles used to develop Ubuntu software are based on the principle of open source software development. In this video, we are going to tackle the basic commands of Ubuntu, like the commands ls, cdir, cd, pwd, mkdir, rmfile, mv, touch, cat, more, head, tail, and cp. The first command is the ls. The ls command is lists files and directories within the file system and shows detailed information about them. The next command, the cddir. The cddir command is a system function system call which is used to change the current working directory. The next command, the cd. The cd or change directory command is used to change the current working directory. The next basic command is the pwd commands. The pwd commands is like ls and cd, is one of the most frequently used Linux utilities. It shows the current location of your directory. The next command, the mkdir. The mkdir command is a Unix allows users to create or make a new directories. The next basic command is the rm command. The rm command is used to remove or delete a file in a Linux from the command line. The next basic command is the cp command. A cp command, for short, for copy, is a command used for copying files and directories in Linux. The next basic command is the mv command. The mv command, short from move, is used to rename and move files and directories from one location to another. The next basic command is the touch command. The touch command is a basic from Linux command to create empty files or change files timestamp. The next basic command is the cat command. The cat command, for short, concatenate, which means to add, is a command used to add more inputs to the file. The next basic command is the more command. The more command is used to view the text files in a command prompt. The next basic command is the head command. The head command is used to view the first 10 lines in a text file. The next basic command is the tail command. The tail command is used to view the last 10 lines in a text file. Execution phase, to be executed by Dave Zachary.
Hello everyone, in this part I'm gonna talk about the execution of the Ubuntu commands. So the first command that I'm gonna execute is ls. So the ls just lists all the files and directories while classifying them into what type they are. So here we go, file, test, and yamero. As shown in the desktop behind the terminal, we can see that test is highlighted as blue because it is a folder file, while the file and yamero are just highlighted as white because they are just files. It is important to note that you can also use dir, but the problem is it doesn't highlight test as blue because it just basically lists everything that is included in your directory. So if you use ls, it's gonna highlight the folders. And if you just use dir, it's not gonna highlight anything, it's just gonna show everything that is inside your directory. The next command is the cd command. Just like in CMD, the cd is used for change directories. So if you want to change directories, say for example you want to go to the test folder, you have to type in cd test. So if you click enter, you are now in the cd test, in the directory of test. Now if you check test, it is an empty folder as of now. So if you want to go back, you can also use the same command used in CMD, and you're back in the desktop. The next command that I'm going to talk about is the pwd command, which roughly translates to pathway directory. So what this does is that it lists the pathway to your current directory. So in this case, desktop is located at home, Dave, then desktop. Say for example, we go to the test folder and then just locate that where that is. We can see that test is inside desktop, and we can see that desktop is inside Dave, and so on and so forth. We can see the pathway if we use the pwd command. The next command that I'm gonna talk about is the rm command. Now let us go back to desktop first. So the rm command is used to remove files. For example, if I want to remove the file name file, I just have to type in rm space its file name. So in this case, the file name is just file. If I click enter, that is gone. And that's just about it. If I try to delete another one, file name Yamero, it will also delete that folder. So the next command that I'm going to talk about is the cp file or the copy file. So it just basically works more like the cmd command. The difference is that it is simplified into a cp more than a copy one. So if we use cp, we specify the file name and then the pathway. So like for example, the pathway is test. If we hit enter, it's gonna copy that file into the test. So let's check. CD test and ls. So here we have it. We have copied the file, and there are now two file name files. So another one is move command. So if you use move command, it basically lets us move a file into a pathway, into a directory. So for example, if I want to move Yamero into test, then I simply have to type in mv space the file name and space the pathway. So click enter, and my Yamero is now moved into the directory of test. Here we go. The next command is called the touch command. The touch command is a command that is used to create files. So for example, I want to create another file. Let's say Onegai. I'm gonna create a file with the name Onegai. So if I click enter, it's gonna show up on my desktop. The same goes if we create something in the test folder. So if we say touch onegai, then if we check the directory, there is now an onegai file name. That is how you create a file using touch command. The next command is cat, which is a shortcut for concatenate. Concatenate means to add. So if we say cat and then file, it's gonna add something to your file. So if we add numbers in it, we can add numbers in the file. Without editing the file itself, we can just use this command to add something. So let's say up to 20. 18, 19, and 20. And how to end this process is you just have to close the terminal, and then you can open it again. So if we check file, let's say for example, to check file, you can use the more command. So for example, we want to check the file, so we type in more file. Sorry, there seems to be a problem here. Wait, more file. Here we go. So it's in the test directory, and if we use more file, we can see into the file without clicking into the file itself. So there is our edited numbers. There's another way of viewing files, but this is a more of a practical way if your files are your file lines are too long. So for example, you have a 500 line text file there and you just wanted to know which file it is, you can just use head file to check the first 10 lines so that you don't have to be overwhelmed with 500 lines in your screen. So if you use head file, it's gonna check the file at its 10 first lines. So there you go, 10 lines. Now if you want to view the last 10 lines, then you can use the tail file. If we hit enter, it's gonna show up 11 up to 20. And that concludes our tutorial. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys soon.